In this video, we're looking at a problem where we're given the mass of a rock resting on a lake bed, and that mass is 10 kilograms. The other thing we know in this problem is the normal force on the rock exerted upward by the lake bed, and that's 60 newtons. In part A, we're asked to make a force diagram for the rock and compute the buoyant force, and in part B, we're going to get the density of the rock. So we'll go ahead and start things out with the force diagram, and we have two forces pointing up. That's the normal force and the buoyant force. One force pointing down. That's the force of gravity. And this rock is in equilibrium, so all those forces have to balance. So we've got our force vectors into the diagram, and this one's the normal force, little n. The second upward force is the buoyant force. And finally, the downward force is the weight of the rock, mg. Now, because the rock is in equilibrium, all of these forces must balance. So the sum of my upward forces, that's n plus the buoyant force, better be equal to the sum of all the downward forces. That's just mg. This allows us to quickly solve for the buoyant force. That's mg minus n. We know the mass of the rock is 10 kilograms. We're going to use 9.8 for g. And we were given the normal force as 60 newtons. So this is 98 newtons minus 60 newtons. In other words, the buoyant force is 38 newtons. Next, we want the density of the rock. And this is a little bit trickier than part A. We know the buoyant force depends on the volume of the rock, because the buoyant force is equal to the weight of the water it displaced by being submerged. Once we have that volume, we'll be able to compute the density. So we'll start by just stating Archimedes' principle. And so the buoyant force is the density of water times the volume of the rock times g. And what we're looking at here in the first two terms, the density of water times the volume of the rock, that's the mass of the displaced water. When we multiply that by g, we get the weight of the displaced water. Archimedes' principle says that the buoyant force is equal to the weight of fluid that's been displaced. So we're able to solve this for the volume of the rock, and that's the buoyant force divided by the density of water times g. Plugging in the numbers, we have a buoyant force of 38 newtons. The density of water is approximately 1,000 kilograms per cubic meter, and g is 9.8. This gives us an approximate volume of 0.003878 cubic meters. Finally, to get the density of the rock, all we have to do is take the mass of the rock and divide by its volume. That's 10 kilograms over 0.003878 cubic meters. Into three significant digits, we get 2,580 kilograms per cubic meter for the density of the rock, and we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.